Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a little different in that I'm going to be responding to another YouTuber's video about drama channels. Now, over time, I've seen a few videos from various YouTubers discussing drama channels and the toxicity we spread throughout the beauty community, but I've never felt compelled to make a video reacting to same until today. For those of you who are unaware, for whatever reason, my channel is categorized as a drama channel. Although I've had many people, including major beauty influencers, tell me that they don't consider my channel to be a quote-unquote drama channel, technically, my channel is a drama channel. Generally speaking, drama channels are frowned upon and viewed as trashy internet tabloid bullies who sit and gossip about successful people because they have nothing better to do with their sad and pathetic lives. I can't even tell you how many times I've been told to go get a real job and focus on your own life, or you're pathetic for making money talking about other people who have achieved success in their lives. Well, I'll let you in on a little secret. It's a business. Newspapers and magazines have been doing it since the beginning of time. From there, TMZ, Perez Hilton, and other entertainment news sites and outlets were born, which then crossed over to television and has now spread to YouTube. It's called evolution, and being that there is such a large beauty community and beauty influencer following on YouTube where some of these influencers are viewed as celebrities, it makes perfect sense for there to be channels who discuss these quote-unquote celebrities. It's just a different platform than you're used to. For those of you who don't consider beauty influencers to be of celebrity status, I encourage you to take note of the crowds influencers such as Jeffree Star, Manny MUA, and Jaclyn Hill draw in. They are celebrities in this community, so much so that celebrities need them to sell their products. Gone are the days where celebrities have the power to sell, especially when it comes to the beauty industry. It's all about influencers these days, so I'll never understand why people are so perplexed as to why channels exist to talk about and report on them. We're not reinventing the wheel over here. That being said, not every drama channel is created equally. You have some that are full-on slanderous and malicious, then there's others who present the facts and let you form your own opinion based on the information provided, and then there's others that will leave you sitting there scratching your head wondering what your life has come to. Not all beauty channels are created equally either. Some lie out of their asses and some don't. Same goes for drama channels, which brings me to Jordan Byers' March 25th video titled Calling Out YouTubers. Now, I have never made a video about Jordan, but I do speak to other channels and she isn't being entirely truthful with respect to her experience with drama channels, and I'm not going to sit back and allow her to preach about positivity in the beauty community while speaking negatively about us and neglecting to mention that it was her own stupidity which led to multiple videos being made about her, so let's get into it. Jordan Byers is a 19-year-old YouTuber with close to 400,000 subscribers whose channel consists of beauty-related videos. She made a name for herself on YouTube by testing counterfeit makeup products and then ranting about how she got chemical burns from same. One of said videos currently sits at 6 million views. If you still can't place her, she's the one who recently declared that she's the only one permitted to use the words brutally honest review in video titles, as she claims to have built her channel on a series in which she gives brutally honest makeup reviews. Recently, Manny MUA dared to use the words in the title of his own videos, which resulted in Jordan publicly accusing him of quote-unquote steamrolling her and stealing the words brutally honest from her series. My understanding is that she and Manny DM'd about the situation. I guess he agreed not to use the words going forward. Then Jordan publicly shaded him. Manny lost respect for Jordan and continued to use the words brutally honest in his titles. Jordan then publicized their DMs, threw a fit on Twitter, once again accusing Manny of stealing from her. Manny responded saying that she's wrong for thinking that her channel revolves around two words and that she's become successful due to her own charisma and charm, and she should be focused on that and not a title. That's the tea in a nutshell with respect to that issue. There are plenty of videos on YouTube if you're interested in hearing more about it. Anyway, she uploads her Calling Out YouTubers video on March 25th in which she talks about the state of the beauty community being unacceptable and how she believes that everyone should come together to bring more positivity to the community. She goes on to say that she wants to make a change and that it's basically a collective effort to do so and so on. Then on the heels of her motivational speech and seemingly out of nowhere, she segues into how she's sick of drama channels exploiting people as seen in this clip.
I'm sick of drama channels exploiting and falsely reporting news that's not even the truth.
First of all, Ms. Byers, if you have issues with a specific drama channel or drama channels, name them and don't generalize and group us all together. This situation stems from her own stupidity where she decided that she was going to do a brutally honest review of Cookie and Cosmetics, which, by the way, has been her most successful video in terms of views since her July 10th, 2017, brutally honest review of Jeffree Star's Chrome Summer Collection. Now, most of us know the history of John Cookie, and if you don't, Google him, yo, you'll be busy for a month straight. Anyway, Jordan decided to review his controversial Cosmetics line and gives this disclaimer at the beginning of her video.
I literally just went onto his website, ordered a couple of things that I thought were cool, and then let it be. So I'm not super filled in on all of the drama and all that jazz that went behind this, but I just do want to state that I'm not reviewing the person, or this is not a drama channel. I'm not gonna be talking crap about people. I will be telling my honest opinions about the actual products and how they perform and et cetera, et cetera. This is not about the person, but instead about the actual makeup. Let's not turn this into something different. This is not a drama channel. I do not condone drama channels, but I am reviewing the makeup. So let's get straight into it.
She says she doesn't condone drama channels, yet here she is endorsing the brand of the most problematic drama channel on YouTube. So people started coming for her, and she of course claimed ignorance to John's past, come to find out that she was at one point a fan of John's, followed him on social media, and was part of his cookie fam. She knew about his past, and she knew that video would bring in views. She's a YouTuber, she knows what time it is. Although she does come clean about enjoying drama channels prior to being a subject of them in her calling out YouTubers video, this was not something she disclosed at the time of her cookie and cosmetics review. Only after she was called out for claiming ignorance to John's past did she own up to it, because receipts don't lie, and there are tweets of her fawning over John and commenting on his videos. This next clip was the catalyst for this video, because it is a complete and utter lie on her behalf.
I'm tired of these drama channels making up stories and not asking the person they are publicly humiliating, publicly defaming. I can tell you, I have so many drama channels make videos about me, about what I've said, about what I've tweeted, but not one of them has asked me what my side is. Nobody has asked me, personally DM'd me, asked me, hey, what's your side of the story? What's your input on this? No one has. Isn't that a little bit weird?
I know for a fact that she was contacted in regards to issues pertaining to her video on cookie and cosmetics. I'm sure DMs can be produced if that person wishes to do so. You're a liar, Jordan. If it were my receipt or DM to show, I would, but unfortunately, it's not. Maybe it'll come out in the next few days, but I can say that she is 100% lying, which seems to be a common theme with her. By the way, while she's sitting up there stereotyping drama channels, anyone that's familiar with how I run things on my channel will tell you that I always reach out to influencers for statements, etc. And I know there are others who do so as well. In fact, I would have reached out to Jordan for this particular video, but she has me blocked, likely for agreeing that she doesn't own the words brutally honest. Other than that, I've never spoken to the girl. I know she has other channels blocked as well, so if you want to be contacted prior to being the subject of a drama video, unblock everyone. Are we supposed to send a smoke signal for you? It's also interesting to me how she makes this video when there are literally no drama channels talking about her. The John situation was 3 months ago, and her last temper tantrum with respect to Manny was 2 to 3 weeks ago, in which she garnered a couple videos made by smaller drama channels. Why is she talking about drama channels now? Is Manny's teat run dry? Nothing left to suckle out of him? I'm just confused. Actually, that's a lie. I'm not confused at all. I'll tell you what I think is going on here. Jordan's channel isn't doing as well as it once was, and she knows drama brings the views. She knows she's gonna get a reaction by putting up a video calling out YouTubers. She's exhibited attention-seeking behavior throughout her entire YouTube career with the crazy thumbnails and exaggerated reactions to receiving chemical burns from unregulated ingredients used in counterfeit makeup. This is nothing new, she's just using a different approach to get views, which is fine. Everyone on YouTube does it for the views, but Jordan wants to play victim to the drama channels while using them to grow her channel. And yes, I do realize that I'm giving her exactly what she wants, but I won't let her sit up there, lie, and lump all drama channels together while doing so under the facade of a kumbaya moment. You want to sit there and talk down on all drama channels for being negative tabloid bullies when some of us are actually out here trying to affect change in the beauty community? No, if you're gonna come for us, you better come correct, honey. Some of us have made positive changes in this community, and I won't let you diminish, same with your blanket statement. Again, Jordan, if you have issues with specific channels, name them, because as I said in the beginning, we're not created equally. We are creators just like you, and we've also worked hard to get where we are. You may not respect our genre, but respect our hustle, because as you said in your video, YouTube isn't easy. By the way, you guys, I'm not saying that everyone has to like drama. drama channels, that's not it at all. I know drama isn't for everyone, trust me, I get it. However, I'm not gonna let someone make a video and watch them lie about a situation when I know the truth. Anyway, you guys, I felt the need to, I guess, defend the situation because I wasn't directly involved, but I did want to share my thoughts and let you guys know that Jordan hasn't been brutally honest in this particular situation. As usual, let me know your thoughts below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys again soon in my next video. Bye!